Hey there, it's Wake Angel 2001, and I have kind of been talking about this a little bit, so I know there might be some people in anticipation. Yeah! It is the arrival of my brand new 3D printer! And as you can tell, this one's quite a bigger model. It is a Monoprice, the same brand as the one that I previously been using, but this is a much larger model. I'm kind of forgetting off the top of my head what it is, so I'm not gonna stumble across that. But hopefully this bigger and more high-end device will result in better prints for all of you. For a point of comparison, the Mini Delta, which is the model that I've been using, is a very nice but very basic printer. It runs about $150-ish, somewhere $130-150 or so, last I checked. And it's like considered like a ground level printer, something to get into it for the first time. But I've been finding that as I try to make more complicated things, particularly the heads of characters like Princess Sally and Rouge the Bat, that I have to do a lot of sanding to smooth them out, and even extra sculpting to get rid of things, you know, like lines in the back of the head. No good. So hopefully, like, a printer like this, which I do believe this might be similar to the model that Sacred Studios use, and when he sent me those prints, they looked much cleaner. So I'm hoping that I'll get cleaner print jobs, and that will allow me to churn out more figures faster, you know, not having to do so much work on them. Alright, so let's reposition the camera, and so that we can look into the box as I open this up, and let's find out what's in there. Okay, so here is the box. I figure, before I actually get into this, this is the head of Princess Sally, one of the last things I printed with the Mini Delta printer. As you can see, this is what the back of the head always looks like initially. Like, it has all these concentric rings and like all this ridging, and then look at her hair points. It's a tangled mess. I practically had to cut them off and re-sculpt them, which wouldn't be too terrible, except that it kind of screwed up her face too. Like, the tip of her muzzle has like a bump on there. It's like she has a mustache underneath her nose. So I don't know how well it's coming along because this is all white filament. But the point is, I didn't like my prints coming out like that because there's so much I have to fix afterwards, I may as well be sculpting them. So, we are now going to hopefully have better quality prints with a better quality printer. Alright. Stop, read this before unpacking your printer. That's the first thing it says. Okay, let's stop the camera so I can read this. Okay, so there was just a warning that if the printer goes wrong, don't take it back to the store, contact them, and a very comprehensive instruction manual, which is more than my last printer came with. I don't think my last printer had an instruction manual at all. And inside, got two big old blocks of foam holding the printer in place. So I think the safest way to extract this will be to lie it down and gently slide it out. Oh boy. Oh boy. Oh, look at this! They actually provided a starter sample of filament. That's more than my last printer came with. Okay. Let's gently rotate. Gently slide. Ooh, got static. Alright, got a power switch here. That's where the plug adapter goes. Back here. Ah, this is probably what was the source of the rattling. Alright, got the thing that the spool hangs from. a 256 megabyte micro SD card, probably for putting models in. Power cord, USB cable, power cord, a bunch of different size Allen wrenches for maintenance, a little tiny wrench, screws, assembly stuff, spatula, all right. Yep, everything you need to assemble your printer. And this is the delicate part. Oh boy. Yes, the screen. Okay, I missed that one. Nothing else back there. There's a lot of wires here. I don't think I want to slide this out on camera because trying to keep everything aligned, I might break something. So let's cut the camera off again. Okay, so here she is, fully assembled. She's a big girl. My original plan was that I was going to set her up in the same place where the old printer was, but as you can see by how much bigger a footprint it has, that's simply not going to be happening. So I'm going to have to set that up in a different place. In addition, this is its power cord. Yeah, this pitiful little wire is not even 3 feet long, so it has to be very close to an outlet. I don't know what they were thinking. I mean, what, were they being charged by the inch of cable? So, yeah, there's gonna be stuff involved here. Yep. So there is the little nozzle, the build plate. It's cool, on this thing, the nozzle moves side to side like this, and the build plate moves forward and back. So instead of just being a single nozzle that moves in all four directions, the plate and the nozzle both move, and they each only move in two directions. So that's pretty cool. So I guess there's nothing for it except for me to hook this thing up, connect it to my systems, and try and print something. So yeah, we'll see if that's a success or not.